In data communication, frequently we are using the terms like modem, data communication equipment. In short, we may denote this as DCE, and data terminal equipment. In short, we may denote this as DTE. Here, modem means it is used to convert the digital signals to audio frequency tones and transmitted tones back to digital information is called a modem. This term is a contraction of modulator and demodulator. The second one, data communication equipment, means modems and other equipment used to send serial data over long distances are known as data communication equipment. The third one is data terminal equipment. Here, the terminals and computers that are sending or receiving the serial data are referred to as data terminal equipment. Now, I will explain you universal, synchronous or asynchronous receiver or transmitter. In short, it can be denoted as USART. The pin number of this USART we are going to use is I251A. Here, the main usage of the USART is, now I will explain. Here, this is the block diagram of USART 8251A. Here, this USART is going to be interfacing the microprocessor unit and peripheral device. The main function of the USART is, the USART accept data characters from the microprocessor unit in the parallel format and converts them into continuous serial data stream for transmission. This is the block diagram showing parallel data is going to receive from microprocessor unit to the USART, and this parallel data is going to be converted into serial form. This serial data is going to be transferred to the peripheral device, and similarly it can be receive serial data streams and convert them into parallel data characters for the microprocessor unit. So, when it is going to receive the serial data from the peripheral device, this serial data is going to be converted into parallel form for the microprocessor unit. So, the main function of USART is conversion data from parallel to serial and simultaneously from serial to parallel. Here, the USART is a 28-pin IC. The pin configuration of IC is, now I am showing. Here, this is the block diagram of 8251A USART. In this block diagram, it consists of 5 number of blocks. Those are data bus buffer. This is the data bus buffer block. Second one, read or write control logic. This is the read or write control logic block. Third one, modem control. This is the modem control logic block. Fourth one, transmitter control. These two blocks are going to show the transmitter control block. Receiver control. These two blocks are going to show the receiver control block. And it also consists of serial to parallel conversion and parallel to serial conversion. It is using a hardware circuit, that is shift register. In the transmitter buffer block, it consists of a shift register for parallel to serial conversion. In receiver buffer block, it consists of a shift register for serial to parallel conversion. Now, I will explain you each block of USART in detail.
The first one is data bus buffer block.
Here, coming to the data bus buffer block, it consists of 8 parallel lines D7 to D0 connected to the system data bus as shown in the figure, so that data words and control or status words can be transferred to and from the device. Coming to the second one, read and write control logic. In this block, it consists of chip select signal. By using this chip select signal, when it is low, 8051 is going to be selected. Suppose the chip select signal here mentioned that it is a active low signal. Means when we are receiving 0 on this pin, that 8251A USART is going to be selected. If we are going to receive 1 on this pin, the 8251A USART is not going to be working. Second pin, C/D complementary, means these are indicating control pin or data pin, is a input pin. When it is low, data address is selecting, and when it is high, control address is selected. When we are receiving 0 on this pin, data address is going to be selected. When we are receiving 1 on this pin, control address is going to be selected. Now another pin, that is clock pin. This clock is a input pin used to generate internal device timings and is normally connected to clock generator output. The other two more pins are read and write pins. These pins are active low pins used for read and write operations. Now coming to the third block, that is modem control. Here in this modem control, it consists of 4 signals: DSR, DTR, RTS, CTS. These 4 signals all are active low signals. When these are receiving 0 on this pin, these pins are going to function. Otherwise, they will not work. Coming to the first signal, DSR means data set ready. This signal, this input pin is normally used to check if the data set is ready when communicating with a modem. Coming to the second signal, DTR means data terminal ready signal. This output pin is used to indicate that the device is ready to accept data when the 8251A is communicating with a modem. Coming to the third signal, RTS means request to send the data. Here, by using this pin, this is an output pin used to indicate the modem that the receiver is ready to receive a data byte from the modem. Coming to the fourth signal, CTS means clear to send the data. This is the input pin used to enable the 8251A USART to transmit the data. Now coming to the fourth and fifth blocks, they are transmitter and receiver blocks. Here coming to the explanation of transmitter and receiver blocks, it consists of S pin. Transmitter data signal is the actual serial data output, and receiver data signal is the actual serial data input pin. It also consists of the shift registers in the USART, require clocks to shift the serial data in and serial data out. And the some more pins, it consists of transmitter clock signal. This is the transmitter clock signal, is the transmitter shift register clock input pin. Another pin, that is receiver clock signal, is the
receiver shift register clock input pin. By using these two pins, transmitter clock signal, receiver clock signal pins controls the rate at which character is to be transmitted for the device. The baud rate is equal to the transmitter clock frequency in synchronous transmission mode. Coming to the asynchronous mode, here in asynchronous mode, the baud rate is one of the three fractions, that is 1 time or 1 by 16th time or 1 by 64th time of clock frequency. In most of the systems, the transmitter clock signal and receiver clock signal frequencies are equal. So, this completes the explanation of universal, synchronous or asynchronous receiver or transmitter.